Thank you. Yeah, let me tell you, it was a lot colder than this tech on this morning.
Yeah,
I was so cold. 10 o'clock in the morning up here. Oh,
yeah. You do up here all the time.
No,
this year, right?
Ooh, what a first you said for a day before the sound.
So it's a dead cat.
Should have told him to write a song about Knoss.
What did Smothers say with your mind?
32 shoulders.
Well, hold me down.
Hey, guys. How come Smothers...
Thank you.
Thank you. all stored in this one. Shortly thereafter, Bod made three big mistakes. You all know this. The first mistake was called the poodle. Actually, he made four mistakes, but that's a surprise time. The second mistake was called Man, and the third mistake was called Little Man. The fourth mistake was inventing the game of backgammon. How many say amen to it? You a lecture on the origin of the process of poodle seduction, but tonight we're going to deviate from that slightly because a marvelous event occurred this afternoon while we were trying to get to your lovely city. I'll tell you about it. 9 o'clock in the morning, we get a wake-up call. We got to get up. We're in Pittsburgh, see? 9 o'clock, up in the morning to get two planes to come here with a two-hour layover in Philadelphia. You know what I mean? It's not easy to get to this place. It's a lot of fucking trouble, actually. Now, we have this road manager. Now, this poor guy, he hardly sleeps at all. He's the one that has to wake up before we do to make sure that we get up and go where we're going. He goes to bed after we do because, you know, he's that kind of person. This is Bruce Sachs, ladies and gentlemen. He's also Tony Orlando's road manager. I don't know what Tony calls him, but we call him Bubba because this son of a bitch can't tell a joke or the chef. But that's okay. That's okay. He's a very nice person. How about there would be two dudes? No, there were two men. No, there were two dudes. All right. Well, anyway, here's what happened. We got to Philadelphia, and a challenge was made. Now, Mr. Smothers, our scoutmaster, has just recently learned to play the game of backgammon, but he learned real good, real fast, beating everybody. And they made a bet. This is about the evils of gambling, folks. They made a bet that if Smothers lost the game, he had to grow hair. And if he lost the game, he had to remove all the hair that was on his face for the period of 1 year. And as you can see, Bruce bit the bag in Philadelphia. It was a tense game, ladies and gentlemen. And so, I want you to watch carefully. You can sing along while Bruce gets shaved. The name of the song is Stink Face.
Completely under rehearsed. It's not like we do this every day.
We want to make sure that he's for as long as he's gonna have the Elvis look. What do you say, Mr. Muffin?
I guess so.
Would you mind telling the people in the audience what exactly you're doing? Describe your technique.
Thank you.
Call me Rudy. Any boy is not paid up on your car.
Glass of wine. Glass of wine. Thank you.
Pittsburgh for the first time.
Thank you. Come on.
extravaganza for you, direction the ultimate elsewhere. A simple little tune entitled Bars Needs Women.
Stuck under this ball, and knew it looked to be like
skin. I said, you son of a bitch, cause I was mad at him. Well, he just got out his walls and started swinging his fang. So I shot him with my shooters in him. The sucker just laughed and said, put it away, you know I ain't a hawk. Now what you gonna say? You ain't my prison.
Yeah, it isn't all.
Well, what about the beard?
For the can this time.
Even her boots?
Now would I lie to you?
Shit, you must have been hungry.
Yeah, this is true.
Don't they pay you good for the stuff that you do?
But you know I can't complain when the checks come through.
Well, I want my prison. I want my beard. Cue me back up, boy. Do you hear?
Blow it out your ass, Lord Psycho Man. I mean, I am the devil. Do you understand? Just what will you give me for your titties and beer? Don't you notice this little blonde back here?
You're goddamn right. You son of a whore. That's about the only reason I learned riding for. Give me that paper. You bet your ass I'll sign. Cause I need a beer in this titty squeezy time.
Man, you can't fool me. You ain't that bad. I mean, you should have seen some of the souls that I had. But there was Fieldhouse Nixon and you two. And both of those suckers were some cute.
Oh, let's make a deal, man, if you think that's true. I mean, you're the devil. What you gonna do?
Wait just a minute. Let me get something straight.
Put it to your blunt, buddy.
What do you mean?
Listen here. You can have my soul. It's a mean little sucker, about 1,000 years old. Once you get it, you can't give it back. You've got to keep it forever, and that's a natural matter. Because I want my Chrissy, and I want my beer.
Now,
do you? I'm quite crook. I'm a simple guy. I only want a few things out of life. Give me some beer, give me a little hockey, give me a little football, give me a little baseball. Give me a stomach that goes like this and a t-shirt and some beer. And I want this. I want big beer. No breasts, no bosom, titties.
Wait a minute.
No falsies, I want titties.
I don't want
neither of
you guys. Wait.
No mashed potatoes,
I said I want titties. You guys are too weird.
What?
I don't want, wait, hold on. Now wait.
Thighs?
Wait.
No
thighs.
Wait.
Turn. Wait a few more
turns.
Wait. Goddamn hell. Hold on. Wait.
Jobson on keyboards. other album is called Black Napkins. Thank you.
Thank you. Oh, coming to the show.
Thank you.
he's a man, but he only was a puppet. No, he's a swimmer, and he's a result of doing nothing.
Here we go!
That's her. I'm Frank.